Hey, the Mr. Excel podcast is sponsored by Easy Excel. Episode 1279, Kill the Button. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel netcast. I'm Bill Jell, and today's question sent in by Greg. Greg has a workbook set up by someone who no longer works for the company, and there's some macro buttons in the workbook. Greg would like to either move them, or he said, really, I just want to get rid of them. How can I get rid of them? And, you know, the problem is, here's two different buttons. These buttons, there's two kinds of buttons in Excel. There's something called a form control and an ActiveX control. And, you know, I didn't see Greg's workbook. I said, the first thing you have to figure out is if you have a form control or an ActiveX control. If you have a form control, well, then it's pretty simple. Of course, if you left-click on it, it runs the macro. That's not what we want to do. So you want to right-click on the button. Now, you have a few options here, cut, copy, and so on, or you can just left-click then, which selects the button. We can now delete that button. We can move the button. We can resize the button. We can do whatever we need to do with that regular old form control button. So now, again, right-click and then left-click to choose the button. A few people say, hey, no, just control-click, and that'll just select the button. That's true. That works as well. For whatever reason, I right-click. Now, this kind of button, though, is an ActiveX button. Oh, these are a little bit tougher because you have to go into something called design mode. Of course, if we click the button, it runs the macro. Okay, well, now ActiveX controls, you need either the ActiveX toolbar in Excel 2003 or in Excel 2007. You would go to the old Office icon, choose Excel Options, Show Developer tab in the ribbon. Excel 2010, we're going to right-click the ribbon, customize the ribbon, and make sure to choose Developer. It's usually unchecked. And then you have the Developer tab. On the Developer tab, you can come over here and go into Design Mode. Design Mode. If you're back in Excel 2003, look for this same icon, although much smaller. First icon on the toolbar there. We'll go in Design Mode. Once we're in Design Mode, then we can choose the button and press Delete to get rid of it. All right, so I sent both of those to Greg, and he writes back and he says, not working. What do you mean it's not working? No, I do it. It doesn't go away. All right, so check this out. I'm going to control click and press delete. Oh, still there. Control click, press delete. Oh, still there. All right, now pause it on your iPod. Go back and replay that. And I want you to watch right up here in the name box and you'll get a clue. I'm going to control click. Look at that. This is button 7. For whatever reason, whoever set up this workbook didn't realize what they were doing, and they ended up creating 10 or 12 buttons that were the exact same size, did the exact same thing right on top of each other. I almost wonder if they did it with a macro, which is possible to do. So when I press delete here to get rid of button 7, there's another one, but that other one happens to be called button 6, and so on. So what Greg had to do was delete until he got rid of all of them. Very maddening. One of those things that, what are the odds of that the guy who set it up accidentally managed to put a whole bunch of buttons there, but he did. All right, so if you need to get rid of a button or move a button, try and right-click it. If that doesn't do it, then you know that you have an ActiveX button. You need to find design mode. Harder to find because most people don't have the developer tab in the ribbon. And then just watch out for the weird case where someone managed to put several buttons all on top of each other, all the exact same size. And when you delete, looks like the thing is still there. Well, hey, I want to thank Greg for sending that question in, and I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast.